Hey, what's up, peoples? Hardleg Joe here with my deck profile for Doctor Who, a trap monster stun deck that features a cast of intrepid time travelers, along with some creepy angel statues. Going over our deck list for monsters, we're playing three of the Doctor, three of his loyal companions, a strangely shaped police box, the butterfly effect, some kind of futuristic snowmobile, I think, and three of the rescue doggos. The rest of our deck is traps, and we're playing three Back to the Future, three ghost farts, three Cybermen, three of the dirt spiders, some crack, three weeping angels, the king of traps, some obscure Doctor Who villain that I've never heard of before, three of the Master, and three copies of the movie Primer. Our extra deck contains The Last Resort, The Biggest Number, Davros, a Dalek, Redoer, MST on Legs, a Very Sleepy Boy, The Last Resort Summoner, The Big Number Summoner, that new Lady Doctor I've heard so much about, An Explosion, A Horse, A Bird, and Bujinki Ahashima. The side deck I'll go over a little bit later. So at first glance, this may seem like a Time Thief deck, because those are the only archetype cards we're playing, but I personally prefer to think of this more as a trap monster deck that just uses Time Thieves as an engine. If you're unfamiliar with trap monsters, they're an interesting subset of continuous trap cards that are all themed around statues for some reason. They share the effect that, when activated, they summon themselves as monsters, while also still being treated as traps. Their playstyle is brought together by these two cards in particular. Statue of Anguish Pattern, when summoned, becomes a level 7 monster with 0 attack and 2500 defense, which cannot be targeted by card effects while you control another trap monster. More importantly though, while this is on the field, anytime you summon a trap monster, you get to target and destroy one card on the field. This is not once per turn, which means if you open with this thing and like four other trap monsters, you will get four quick effect card pops during your opponent's turn. The other major player in this deck, and the newest addition to the trap monster subtype, is Angel Statue Azaroon. This summons itself as a level 4 monster with 1800 attack, 1800 defense, and the following effects. Once per turn, when your opponent would special summon monsters, you can send one trap monster you control to the graveyard to negate the summon and destroy that card. Also, if this card is destroyed by battle, you destroy the monster who did the battling. So yeah, if you have this and Anguish Pattern, you summon the spider, summon Angel at any time to pop a card, and now you have Solemn Warning on Legs that can tribute off the spider or itself to negate the summon of a monster. And if your opponent wants to try to play around that negate by destroying Angel via battle, it will cost them whatever monster they use. It's not an amazing competitive combo by any means, but two disruptions on legs with protection is nothing to sneeze at. Especially when you can follow this up with Time Thief Redoer. If you're unfamiliar with this card, it is a rank 4 Ixie that has two effects. First, during each standby phase, you can equip the top card of your opponent's deck to this thing as Ixie material, which is important for its second effect. It says, during either player's turn, you can detach up to 3 materials from it, and it gains effects depending on what kind of material it detached. If you detached a monster, this card banishes itself until the end phase, letting it dodge out of removal. If you detached a spell, you get to draw a card, which, you know, drawing cards is always nice. If you detach a trap, though, this can put a card that your opponent controls on top of their deck. This is a quick effect, and it does not target. Now, there are several Time Thief cards that allow you to attach stuff to Redoer, specifically so you can make use of that last most powerful effect. However, you don't need to use those if you just make Redoer using a level 4 trap monster. It's worth mentioning at this point that in addition to Azaroon, our other three trap monsters, Brigandine, Tiki Curse, and Zoma the Spirit, are also all level 4. Which means if you can stun your opponent for just one turn with your trap monster negates, you can then use those trap monsters to make a 2400 beater that'll have quick effect non-targeting non-destruction removal. Add to that powerful cards like Crackdown and Solemn Judgment, alongside a small but recursive Time Thief engine, and it's really easy to out-resource your opponent in just the course of two or three turns. And that's really the main crux of the deck, just using these two synergistic playstyles to the best of their ability. You go first, set up your traps, disrupt the opponent on their first turn, and then follow it up by using those traps to make a very powerful redoer. And then if they're still alive after that, you can start pumping out more rank 4s on subsequent turns, because we've got this whole engine just designed to make rank 4s. This deck makes Ixies like crazy, and we've got a whole toolbox of them to deal with different situations. If your opponent is trying to stall with floating monsters, or they have something like Dragoon, then Utopia and Utopia the Lightning is actually a really good way to solve those problems. If they swarm with a bunch of stuff or get some high attack monsters on board, you can go into Raider's Knight, which can then summon Arc Rebellion Dragon, who gains the combined attack of everything on the field. Easy way to OTK. Tornado Dragon deals with spell traps, Heartland Draco can attack directly, allowing you to summon Zeus. If things go wrong, Baguska and Exaton Knight can help you stall to get more resources. And if your redoer is just doing strong on its own, you can always summon Perpetua, who once per turn can target a Nixie monster and attach a Time Thief card to it from the deck, which lets you just keep trap monsters on redoer so you can keep shuffling things away. Speaking of those Time Thief traps, we play two of them, and they are both pretty sweet. Flyback essentially does the same thing the Perpetua does. It grabs a Time Thief trap from the deck and attaches it to an Ixie, most likely redoer. While it's in the graveyard, though, it has a second effect, which can be surprisingly strong. It can banish itself to attach another card to redoer, this time from your opponent's graveyard. Not only is this great for getting spells and traps on redoer from your opponent's stock, but since this is a quick effect, you can essentially use it like DD Crow, plucking stuff out of the grave before your opponent can use it. Their other trap card is a counter trap, which simply reads, while you control a Time Thief Ixie, negate any spell trap, and if you do, attach it to redoer as material. This is just another bit of disruption, something to stop spell trap removal and things like Dark Ruler No More. But the best thing is both of these traps are searchable. Winder, one of our two normal summons, searches a Time Thief card except for himself whenever he's summoned. This pairs really well with Adjuster, who has two effects which are mutually exclusive. The first is, if you summon a Time Thief, you can summon her from the hand, which means her and any of our other Time Thief cards is a rank 4. The second effect is, when she's summoned, send a Time Thief from your deck to the graveyard. There's a lot of targets for this. In addition to flyback, all of our one-ofs have graveyard effects, but 99% of the time, you're sending Temp Wailer. While this is in the graveyard, it can bounce a Time Thief back to your hand to summon itself, which seems fairly useless, but it's actually key to gaining and maintaining card advantage. Like, let's say you summon both of these Time Thieves. Winder searches your counter trap, and Adjuster lets you send Wailer to the graveyard. Well, then you can return Winder to your hand in order to summon Wailer, which allows you to still make a rank 4 using these two, while ensuring that next turn, you can search another counter trap. And you may think that summoning both of these and using their effects is difficult, but that's why we have Regulator, our other normal summon. If you control no other monsters, this friendly doggo can tribute itself to summon two Time Thieves from the deck with different names, allowing you easily to summon Redoer while searching one of our traps and setting up this for an additional turn. And really, that's about it. We have two other Time Thieves. They're one of targets that help you extend and recover. You can dump them in the graveyard with Adjuster or like use Perpetua to equip it to a Redoer and then detach them. Honestly, though, I barely use them, and you could probably replace them with, like, Kage Tokage or any level 4 extender, just something that lets you make rank 4s more often. As for other trap monsters, they have effects, but, none of them are particularly important, except for maybe Shade Brigandine. If you don't know, This thing says if you have no other traps in your graveyard, you can activate this the same turn you set it, which means you can summon it on your first turn, and then make Redoer with a trap card attached as long as you have any monster to normal summon. The other two just have high attack and, like, effects that de-incentivize your opponent from attacking, so that they can hopefully survive for a turn. Honestly, though, there's a few other level 4 trap monsters you could just as easily use them and not lose anything from the core of this deck. It's just a matter of playing enough of them that these two are always online. Likewise, when it comes to Judgment, Crackdown, and even Imperial Order, these are all just tech cards. They could be replaced with any other trap you want, or even spells. That's what a lot of the stuff in the side deck is where you would put this in. Unending Nightmare is my pick for spell trap removal, good against other control decks, although Anti-Spell Fragrance and Draugmatica Punishment could work just as well. Since we're playing so many continuous traps, you could just as easily play Magical Planter for draw power, though I tried that originally and it felt a little slow in the modern game. Nothing in this deck locks you into Ixie, so you could potentially make some big links if you wanted, though I usually end the game long before these are needed, or I lose before I get enough resources to make them. Even if you do want to stay with the rank 4s, there are a few other options you can consider. Castell is nice removal if you don't have access to a trap for Redoer, and Abyss Dweller can be really good, a main deck staple, depending on the format you're playing in. Playing online, I didn't really run into a lot of graveyard decks, but if you're in a tournament, this is probably something you'd want to use all the time. Finally, it's worth noting that this deck does have some synergy with Phantom Knights, with Raid Raptors, and though I didn't put it here, Eldritch of all things. You could try to splash in either of these with parts of this engine, although I'm not sure exactly what you would take out or what ratios you would use. There is the potential for shenanigans, though. And also, there's this thing, this OCG card that doesn't have an official American name. It seems really broken in back row heavy decks, but in all my testing, it hasn't quite made the cut for this or my previous episode. Maybe I'm not using this properly, maybe it just needs to be in a specific meta or something. But I feel like this is something you side in games 2 and 3, when you know your opponent is going to use all the spell trap destruction. So go ahead and experiment what you want. Experiment with this whole deck. That's basically my thing. I make a deck every 2 weeks, I give you an interesting idea, and hopefully you can run with it, make it more than I have time to. But anyway, I've rambled on long enough about this. That's the deck. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe if you enjoy the content, and leave a comment below if you have any questions or suggestions. Until next time, good luck, and have fun.